Hello, welcome to Ellie V Toys. I did not realize that I had missed a Disney princess set. I don't know why it went under my radar. Probably because I've already got a celebration, but this one is a different one, obviously, because it's a different one. This one's aimed at junior builders, so it's a 4+ set, which means it'll just have bigger pieces. There are 114 pieces in here. It's going to be an easier build. It does have a Disney price tag on it, so... But it actually is the first set, I think, in the Ariel line to have all of her friends included in the one set. So it's got Ariel and Eric, and it has got a boat that floats. Look at that. Oh, no, hold on. I got sidetracked. It has got the three friends. It's got Max and Sebastian and Flounder. No villains, of course, because this is a wedding. You do not want Ursula here. Oh, and no sisters or fathers, but the three friends, the three animals, which is really cool, including three books. We got three books, one for each little build. So, okay, this should be nice. And one bag for each book. Ah, nice and easy. We're going to fly through this. So Ariel has got her wedding gown in ball gown form. Finally, it's so pretty. The printing obviously only goes on the front at the moment. That's all we see so far in the ball gowns. But it's gorgeous, it's metallic, it's got all the little filigree curlicue things on the side. The top is lovely, it's embellished as well. Does it have any printing on the back? It does not have printing on the back, which makes me curious. Is this, yeah, it's the old style of torso. Right, okay, so Ariel does not get any printing on the back, but the whole outfit's just gorgeous. Hold on, now I'm looking at her face. Is her eyeliner super heavy as well? Her face print also, I think, don't quote me on this because there have been a lot of Ariel faces and I forget, but I'm pretty sure that this one is like makeuped up. She is super lining up for the wedding. I mean, it's a wedding set and she needs the crown because she's a princess. She's a Disney princess. Without a crown, how would we know? We'd know. And this set also has Prince Eric in it. He is dressed for the wedding in a... we've seen this top before, but... I think it's different. So he's in his formal prince gear. This is the old torso. I like this new one. It's the same design, but it's different colors. Looks nice. I like the new one. I prefer the new one to the old one. His face also, I think, is a slight variation on the old face too. His eyebrows got a little bit more character. His chin's got a bit more character. How does a chin have character? It just does. And his mouth's got a little bit of a quirk. Nice. They are ready for a royal wedding, but we got to build them all the stuff first. Oh, but in the first bag, we also have got, sorry, Prince Eric, we also have got Max. And like I mentioned before, we have got three friends in this set ready for the wedding. So Max is the first of them. We'll meet the others as they come along in the bag. So some subsidiary builds first. We have got a little, once again, when are we ever going to get a dingle hopper as a brush? Since when did Ariel ever use a brush? And there's a bone randomly put in the instructions here now. I don't think we put it on the dressing table. Pretty sure it's for Max. Okay, so we've got a tiny dressing table and now we've got a bit of a watery bit. And I mean, I don't think this is the boat. I don't think this is for the boat. I think this is like a little part for the jetty. So where the boat comes to moor. This is lovely. So just a little platform maybe for the married couple to be displayed on. This is going to make a really nice display once it's all finished. This is gorgeous. It's a portrait of the two, except Ariel has brown hair. What? And Eric has got brown hair. What? Neither of them have the correct hair color. And yet somehow we know that it's them. But I don't understand why Ariel doesn't have red hair and Eric doesn't have black hair. Why? You know what, though? I've only just recently noticed the little curlicues inside these arched frames. I don't know if they've always been there. I think they probably have. And I only just noticed them and they're just so lovely. Okay, flowers and a spinny platformy thing. And that's it for this part of the build. So this is definitely going to be either for a wedding dance or it'll make a really nice display area. This is what we've got at the end of bag one. Now we start into bag number two, which is, oh, this is the bag that Eric actually is supposed to come in, and I pinched him. So pinched him out, nicked him out. So he is supposed to have a little subsidiary bit too, a little extra part. It's just a table with some chairs. Bring out the champagne. It's a celebration. Okay, now it is time for the boat. And these two parts have already gone together, so look at that. There's not a lot of building to do. And this boat is sealed on the bottom, so it is designed to float. which is very cute. It's always fun to have a boat that floats, also because it rhymes. I like these printed pennant pieces. They're actually not so cutesy that you can't use them in another build. They're really pretty. They're very, very pretty. So they are decorating the side of the boat. Got one of these nice big long tiles with the jumper studs. Some of these little rounded pieces. And this you normally see on the bonnet of a car. But on this situation, we're seeing it on the bonnet of the boat. Do boats even have bonnets? This one does now. So this is the front of the boat. This is being built up nicely. Some gold flourishes and a crown. Because we wouldn't know as royal if we didn't put gold flourishes and crowns all over it. We get so confused. This part here is designed to be the top deck, I think. The top deck of the boat. So nice and simple. There's not a lot of actual building to go in here, but there's still enough building to make it interesting. It does make really, really nice little display and play pieces. Here's the steering wheel. Oh man, is it called a steering wheel on a boat? I know I've asked this before. It's just going to be, it's the wheel, the boat's wheel. That looks really great, except there's this big hole underneath, which you can fill with water. Below decks is looking pretty bare. And yeah, fill that with water, it's not going to float for very much longer. Got a couple of flags just to show that the ship is in motion. These go on the back. It's looking lovely. It's looking very, very pretty and very regal. And I'm not sure this is where people are supposed to go, but I don't think it matters. These are left over at the end and yeah. They're not much use at the moment. I'll find some use for them later. Bag number three. Okay. I did mention that we have got Sebastian and Flounder still to go. So this is their own little vignette, their own little scene. And in this trunk, oh, nice. We got a gem, but we've also got a gold ring, which is kind of rare in the Lego world. And another gold ring, which is stuck inside this piece. And we've actually got two. So three gold rings all up and an extra gem. Three gold rings. Only one of them is supposed to go into the trunk, so the rest are spares. You can use them for all sorts of things. But I think we could probably use them for Eric and Ariel to get married. Right, so we have got our treasure chest, and now we're making a little under the sea scene. This is really nice. This is the little watery pedestal for Flounder. And you can see the hook on the front so that the saxophone sits at just the right height for Flounder to play it. Because apparently Flounder plays the saxophone now. That's fantastic. And a spot at the back there for the trunk so it's on an angle so it doesn't get hidden behind all the other stuff that's going in front. This is a spinny bit. And this one has got the keyboard on it. This is going to be Sebastian. So Sebastian's at work here on the keyboard. With his crabby claws, and that spins around so you can angle him however you want him to, or you can just spin him around in time to whatever you are singing in your head. It might be Under the Sea, it might be any number of other songs. I'm sure you can make them all fit. This fits really nicely here, and it's actually surprisingly secure, that treasure chest there on the back. Okay, so this is their vignette. We have got a trident which has nowhere to actually put it. I'd like somewhere to stick it into, but there is nowhere. It's not supposed to be stuck into anywhere. I'm just gonna just put it on the ocean floor here. Perfect. All right, nice little extras at the end of bag number three, which we've already seen. Let me put them away again. And now we have got three little scenes, or three complete individual stories happening here, which you can combine all together to make a wedding fit for a princess, i.e. Ariel. Ah, this set is just, it's totally worth getting even just for the figures. For Ariel and Eric and for Max and Sebastian and Flounder alone. And then there's the Lego building stuff, which for me is actually quite secondary to the figures. All right, that's it for today for this particular set. There will be more stuff. Go and check out some of the other videos. There are lots of them and there are lots of builds. Check them out. Check back in. More stuff coming up. See you soon.